आई एम डॉक्टर जेसे जॉन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनाटॉमी, युति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर. एंड टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द एनाटॉमी ऑफ द लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम अर्लियर. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम. We have discussed the important terms that are the main component of the lymphatic system, and what is the function of the lymphatic system, how it flows in our body, and how the all the component of the lymphatic system is made up of. Lymph vessels, lymph trunks, and lymphatic ducts, thoracic ducts, and right lymphatic duct, lymph nodes, the structure of the lymph nodes, and the major lymph nodes that's present in our body, that are the cervical lymph node, axillary lymph node, inguinal lymph node, and mesenteric lymph node. Today we will discuss all the major lymph nodes present in our body in detail. So we can see here in this picture the presence of some lymphatic nodes in our body. First we will discuss cervical lymph node, that is located in the area of the neck, and it will filter lymph from the head and neck. So the region of the head and neck, there is the lymph that will filter in this lymph node that present in the neck area. Axillary lymph node are present in armpits, and they will filter the lymph that will come from the hand, arm, and breast region. Inguinal lymph node that is present in the groin area, and they filter the lymph from that will come from the lower extremities and the external genital organs. And mesenteric lymph node that will present in the abdominal peritoneum, and it will aid in infection control after abdominal surgery, and it will filter the lymph that will come from the abdominal cavity. So we have discussed all the major lymph node in a very short. Now we will get the knowledge about the term of the metastasis. Metastasis is the process by which bacteria or body cells are spread from one body part to another through lymphatic or the circulatory system. Cancer cell migrate to nearby nodes, example as a breast cancer to the axillary nodes. So the chemotherapy is necessary once metastasis occurs. So the breast region, the lymph will drain into the axillary node. So it is very possible thing the cancer cell will migrate to the axillary nodes. So chemotherapy is the must when once metastasis is established. Now we will see the diffuse lymphatic tissue. It is not enclosed by the capsule, and it will consist of reticular connective tissue that contain lymphatic nodules, and that will found in small amounts in almost every organ, especially mucous membrane that lines tracts of body. So diffuse lymphatic tissue, it is not a specific lymphatic tissue. We will say the some specific terms because it is not covered by the capsules, and it will diffusely located in the all the in a small amount in almost every organ, and especially the mucous membrane that lines the tracts of our body, where it will found. isolated lymphatic nodules. These are oval shaped concentration of the lymphatic tissue, and these are most of the solitary, small and discrete, and scattered in the lamina propria of the mucous membrane of the gastrointestinal tract and respiratory airways and the urinary and reproductive tract. So these lymphatic nodules, that is oval shaped concentration and solitary, small and discrete, and they will scattered in the lamina propria of the mucous membrane of the gastrointestinal tract, respiratory and urinary and reproductive tracts. Isolated lymphatic nodules, when activated by the antigens, they differentiate into the plasma cell and produce antibodies against specific antigens. Plasma cells secrete immunoglobulin A antibodies, and it will provide protection against bacteria and viral infections in the lumen of the tracts. Isolated lymphatic nodules located in mucous membrane of the gastrointestinal tract, examples, tonsils and ileum of the small intestine, we will see the pear patches, and the mucous membrane of the appendix. Now we will see the some organs that present in our body, and that is fully established by the lymphatic tissue. Tonsils, that is aggregations of the large lymphatic nodules, and it is embedded in the mucous membrane and located beneath epithelium of the pharynx and the oral cavities, and it will protect nasal and the oral cavities. It is three types: nasopharyngeal tonsils, palatine tonsil and lingual tonsils. We can see here in this picture, nasopharyngeal tonsil, palatine tonsil and lingual tonsil. Nasopharyngeal tonsils, commonly called adenoids, and it is located behind the nose and on the roof of the posterior wall of the pharynx and posterior opening of the nasal cavity. So we will see the adenoids that will present behind nose and the roof of the posterior wall of the pharynx and the just behind the posterior opening of the nasal cavity. Now we will see the palatine tonsils. It is referred to the tonsils. Every time we will see the mouth to examine the tonsils. So these are the tonsils, that is the palatine tonsils. They are located in back of the mouth and the lateral wall of the pharynx, and most commonly removed through the tonsillectomy procedure. Lingual tonsils, it is situated on the base of the tongue, and it will first line of the defense from the exterior. Now we will see the spleen. It is the largest lymphatic organ and located in upper left abdomen quadrant, and it is found between the fundus of the stomach and the diaphragm, and it is 5 to 6 inches long and 2 to 3 inches wide, and it resembles a large lymph node and it filters blood. You can see here in this picture the spleen and the sectional and cross-sectional section. We can see the structure of the lymphatic vessels. Structure of the spleen, the capsule, that is the outermost part, and it is the covering of the dense connective tissue, and hilum, it is the depression of the medial surface, and nerves and arteries enter the spleen. Veins and lymphatic vessels exist from the spleen. structure of the spleen, trabeculae. These are the extension of the capsule, form partitions within the spleen, and the pulp present in the inside of the structure in spleen and divided into the red and white pulp. White pulp consists of the lymphatic tissue, and mostly lymphocytes arranged around the central arteries. Red pulp consists of the venous sinuses filled with the blood and the cores of the splenic tissue. It is consists of the red blood cell, macrophages, lymphocytes and plasma cells and granulocytes. Function of the spleen: the phagocytosis of the bacteria and worn out damaged red blood cells and platelets, and it will stores and releases blood in times of demand as in hemorrhage, and functions in immunity as a site of B cell proliferation into plasma cells. Does not filter lymph because it has no efferent lymphatic vessel or lymph sinuses. So these are the process of phagocytosis. Thymus gland, it is two lobed organ and it is located in the upper part of the chest along trachea. It is inferior to the thyroid gland, posterior to the sternum, and it is the largest and most active during prenatal period and infancy, but after puberty it decreases in size and become remnant. It is composed of lymphatic tissue and divided into the lobules, and the immature T cells that originating in the bone marrow migrate to the thymus through blood, and in thymus these cells develop into mature T cells for the further release in the circulation. Thymic hormones aid in maturation of the T cells. So the T cells that is formed in the bone marrow, they are immature, and the blood carry these immature T cell into the thymus gland. Some hormone that present in thymus gland that is responsible for the immature T cell to mature T cells, and then it will release into the blood. Mature T cells travel to lymph nodes, spleen and diffuse lymphatic tissue where they reside. It is responsible for the cell-mediated immune responses. Removal of thymus will call thymectomy, and whenever it removed but decreased T cell production results, and possible acute susceptibility to infection. So if there is removal of thymus, then there will be decreased T cell production, and further there will be acute susceptibility to infection happen there. Removal of the spleen, that we will say splenectomy, and other organ, liver, bone marrow can compensate for it, and the increased susceptibility to decreased disease may result. Now we will see the some disorders of the lymphatic system. Lymphatic system may not carry out its function adequately due to the blockage. So obstruction in the lymphatic system leads to an accumulation of the fluid, that we will say lymphedema. Obstruction may result from the scar tissue that develop when lymph vessels or nodes are damaged or removed during surgery, by radiation therapy, by injury, and topical countries by infection with a thread worm that will called filariasis that blocks the lymphatic ducts. So any region, maybe scar, maybe this parasite, if they obstruct the lymph vessels, the further the edema will develop. We will say lymphedema. So you can see here the lymphedema here, and the parasites cause because they will accumulate in the lymph vessels and they will block the lymphatic drain. So this called lymphatic filariasis. We can see here the whose population is suffering from the filariasis. Cervical lymphadenitis, it is the medical condition which is characterized by inflammation of the lymph nodes in the neck. Granulomatous lymphadenitis, cancer tumor may block the lymphatic ducts and travel to lymph nodes near a tumor, interfering with flow of lymphatic fluid through the node. Rarely a tumor may develop in the lymphatic system. Now we have studied the lymphatic system in two parts and we have understand the whole system. So now you have to assess yourself by the answering these questions. First is explain lymphatic system in the brief and what kind of the lymph nodes that present in the body. You have to explain about it. Thank you.